Today, we will double the speed of the ESP32 and use the second core. And we will only use the Arduino IDE. Let's get started. Greetings, YouTubers. Here is the guy with the Swiss accent, with a new episode around sensors and microcontrollers. The new ESP32 has three cores. Two of them are very fast, the third is ultra low power. The Arduino IDE typically only uses one of the fast cores. Today, we will take full advantage of the second core of the ESP32. We will test if it really increases the capacity of our microprocessor. We will also compare its dual core speed with the speed of an Arduino UNO. We will try to synchronize tasks, even if they run on two different cores. We will also try to use the same data on both cores. These two mechanisms are mandatory if you want to use two cores in a productive fashion. And we will not leave the Arduino IDE. Promised. This video is only possible because Espressive changed something when they implemented the Arduino IDE on the ESP32. They added a real-time operating system called RTOS. And most of us did not notice or care about that. What is a real-time operating system? It is an operating system like Linux or Windows, just very tiny and much less powerful. But it can handle several tasks in parallel, which run independently. Our Arduino sketch, for example, runs as one task. We can check in which core our sketch runs by printing the value of export get core ID. This function returns the core the sketch runs on. And our normal Arduino sketch runs on core 1. I assume that Wi-Fi runs on core 0, but I do not know it for sure. As always, I use blinking LEDs for the tests. First, we want to move this blink function from core 1 to core 0. This is quite simple if you know how to do it. It needs three steps. First, we define a task handle variable called task1. Second, in setup, we create a so-called task pinned to a particular core. And third, we create a void function called code for task1. This code will be executed similar to the loop function. If we recompile and upload our new sketch, including these three parts, nothing changes. The LED still blinks and the sketch runs on core 1. If we transfer the content of loop to our newly created task, we have to add a small something, an endless loop. This for statement makes that our code loops forever. Such a statement was not necessary for the loop, because the Arduino IDE added it automatically. But our code still runs on core 1. If we want to transfer it now to core 0, we have to pin our newly created task to core 0 instead of 1. And here it is. The code runs now on core 0. Goal 1 achieved. The next is to check how fast the ESP32 gets if we can run it on both cylinders. For this, I create an artificial load with some for loops, a floating point, and a few integer calculations to simulate a sketch. At the end of the sketch, the time used for these calculations is printed out. First, we put the code back into the loop section. The whole calculation is done on core 1 and takes about 800 milliseconds. Now we shift the same code into code for task 1. The loop section becomes completely empty. To compare the two, we run code for task 1, also on core 1. But now it takes double the time as before. Why is that? Even if the loop does nothing, it still gets some attention and uses about 50% of the time. How do I know? Look what happens if I put a delay statement into the loop. Now our code for task 1 task is as fast as it was in the loop section. Obviously, loop gets now a lot less attention. Good to know. Now let's do the same thing but switch our load to core 0. it runs full speed. What would you expect if I remove now the delay statement in the loop? You were right. Our task still runs full speed, because loop runs on core 1 and core for task 1 runs on core 0, both with full throttle. Of course, we can use core 1 for more than just doing nothing. What about loading it with the same load as core 0? I copy the code from code for task 1 into loop and fire the ESP up. And what happens? It runs now on both cylinders, just like my Harley Davidson. This is really fun. Of course, we quickly can go back to a single cylinder engine. We just pin our task 1 to core 1, and we are slow again. We could add a second task instead of our loop and pin this task to core 1. The effect is pretty much the same. We will do that in the next section. I was talking about slow and fast. With these remarks, I only compared the ESP32 running on one or two cores in parallel. But how fast is the ESP32 compared with our old Arduino UNO? To compare the two processors, I run the same load on my Arduino UNO clone. It takes 50 seconds to complete the task, not 800 milliseconds as on the ESP32. Compared with running on two cores, the ESP32 therefore is more than 100 times faster. And it costs less than $10. Who wants to complain about that? Now we can run on both cores. And we can, for example, monitor our sensors with one core and do calculations or post the results on the internet on the other core. And both tasks do not interfere. But if we want that the two tasks somehow work together, how can we pass data between these cores? And how can we synchronize the sensor readings with the calculations, even if the tasks run on two different cores? This is a common task for real-time operating systems. And here is an example. I connected two different LEDs to the ESP32 and used my template sketch for two parallel tasks on two cores. I create a blink function in which I can choose the pin and the duration. Then I call this function from both tasks, but with different pins and different durations. Let's see what happens. The two LEDs blink entirely independently. So using the same code made it possible to create separately blinking LEDs. We could add as many LEDs we want and create a task for each of them. But if we wish that these LEDs flash synchronized, for example, that both LEDs blink one after the other, or both LEDs start at the same time with blinking, to do that, we have to synchronize the two tasks. One task has to wait till the other has finished, and vice versa. Synchronization of tasks is done by so-called semaphores. They control access to common resources. In our case, we need a mutually exclusive semaphore. This semaphore behaves like a baton in a relay race. There is only one baton, and the person owning it has to run like hell. And at the end, the baton is passed to the next runner. On our ESP32, we have two functions to deal with this semaphore or baton. Semaphore take and semaphore give. If we want to synchronize tasks, we have to make sure that a task has the baton before it starts its execution, and it has to pass it to the next when finished. Here you see how I did it. The semaphore take function waits till it gets the baton and then starts the blink cycle. After the blink, it executes semaphore give to let the baton free. If we start our sketch, the first task gets the baton and can begin with executing its task. One thing, however, is different than in relay races. The same task can get the baton again if it is faster than the other task. So we add a little disadvantage in the form of a short delay. Like that, the other task has enough time to take the baton. Now our LEDs blink synchronized, one after the other. How cool is that? By just changing the place of the semaphore GIF function in the shorter of the two tasks, the LEDs always start to blink in parallel. Of course, they do not blink the same time, because I choose the duration of the two LEDs differently to show you that the synchronization works. And we do not need to care about all this timing. Our ESP32 does it for us. We also achieved our second goal. The third goal, to pass data from one task or core to another, has a lot to do with range of variables. For today, we choose the most straightforward method. Use global variables which are defined at the beginning of the sketch. These variables can be read and written in all tasks on both cores. And if you use semaphores, you are pretty sure that you do not change a particular variable in the very same moment by two different tasks. Maybe a viewer knows how to do this more professionally, but so far it worked for me. To show the effect, I added a variable called counter and increase it in both tasks. The result works as expected. Summarized, we were able to take full advantage of the second core of the ESP32. We were able to show that it increases the capacity of our microprocessor if we make sure that loop runs idle. We compared the speed of this modern processor with the speed of an Arduino UNO and found that the ESP32 is more than 100 times faster than the old UNO. We discovered a simple way to synchronize tasks, even if they run on two different cores. We were also capable of using the same data on both cores. These two mechanisms are mandatory if you want to use the two cores productively. And all was done without leaving our Arduino IDE, as promised. Of course, there is much more to be said and done in this field, like priorities of tasks. And you will see a few crashes if you start to experiment with these functions. But still, it works, and I'm sure if we start to use it, errors will be corrected by Espressive. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. And I hope you start to experiment with this new world of programming. Bye!